This is the Troy AssurePay installation and configuration. I have my installation package unzipped on my desktop and it is opened. We start going into our fonts folder, right-clicking the fonts inside, install. This will be the only pop-ups that happens. You may have one, two, or maybe even three fonts in here. Number two, Bullzip. Locate the setup Bullzip EXE, right click, and run as administrator. Bullzip's purpose is to generate the print previews within AssurePay. It'll install a Bullzip PDF printer as well as these three add-ons. Select our language. Next, accept. Next, next. Now this is an optional selection that I generally enable. I do not create a start menu folder. And then next. And this will install the Bullzip as well as the three add-ons. And this process generally takes about 5 minutes. After we exit the setup, we are going to close the pop-up browser window. When that's finished, we go back folder to our AssurePay, right-click the setup, or as administrator. Next, accept, next, next, install. And this process generally takes about 5 minutes. When it's done, we click finish, and that is it for the setup. Next, we'll launch the software, log in, and do a couple initial configurations. Once we're at the login screen, we use our super user padlock, password. When we get into the software, the initial configurations we will set where the software will select the batch files for import and also set up a printer. So first of all, we'll go into file integration, use this top drop down, select one of our accounts, and this folder location is the location that the files will be located in. For now, I'm using my Troy databases and I'm looking for text files. Next, you can go into settings, to the printers tab, and click a new item. From here, you can use this drop down box to select a printer local to your machine, or you can use the URN name to select a print server and printer that way. Once you have your printer in there, we click save. And from here, there are two options. We can either go back into the printer itself and assign individual accounts and trays, or we can use this section up here to do it for every account. You can also do continuation or overflow, the reports, or copies. Then we click save. Then close. And if everything's set up correctly, we can click our import button, double click on an account, and then that should take us to the folder we set up with the list of files we can import. There's my two files. We'll import the long one real quick and get a status down here of the process. And here is our batch information. This is just information about the file itself, the account it went into, the date, number of checks, total value. If we click our view detail button, it'll activate our batch details tab. And here you can have more information about each individual check. From here we can select one. Select one, multiples, or individuals, and either print or preview them. If ever we need to, we can also use this selection over here for an override printer to temporarily send a print job to a different printer. you have everything done and you're done with the batch, you can either leave it there for future processing or reprints, or you can remove or archive it depending on what your needs are. Once you're done in the software, you can just close it by hitting the red X in the corner, and then yes to log out, and then the red button to actually shut it down, thus closing the connection to the database and freeing up your license for another user. If you have any installation or support questions, please do not hesitate to contact our Troy technical support team at the information provided on the screen.